Good morning all. Today we'll see a tutorial problem on this frequency sampling filter. So use frequency sampling method to design an FIR low pass filter with cutoff frequency of pi by 4 for the order of filter n equal to 15. Determine the filter coefficients and the system function. So proceeding, as per the step 1, the filter specification is given as HD of e power j omega equal to e power minus j alpha omega. Omega from 0 to omega c and omega c to pi, where it is equal to 0. Transforming this to the problem, the value of alpha is given as center of symmetry 7 minus 1 divided by 2. So 15 minus 1, 14 divided by 2 is 7. So we get e power minus j 7 omega. Cutoff frequency is replaced by pi by 4. So drawing this HD of e power j omega, magnitude response gives, you can observe that the low pass filter is existing. So we are keeping this as 1 because we are considering the magnitude response of this HPF. So magnitude response of e power minus j omega will be equal to, modulus of that will be equal to 1. So it extends from 0 to pi by 4. We very well know that this is symmetrical about, or we can see that it is repeating about pi or symmetrical about pi. So whatever we get over here will get repeated up to 2 pi. And hence 0 to pi by 4 is again repeated over here from 2 pi to 7 pi by 4. Moving on to step number 2. So in step number 2, h of k value is found out by applying HD of e power j omega for different values of omega equal to 2 pi k divided by n. So e power minus j alpha, h of k is e power minus j alpha 2 pi k by n. So here we go for the direct shortcut method in compared to your previous method, that directly we take the value of k as 0, 1, 2 up to n minus 1. I would like to recollect in the previous video that we have seen in detail how to calculate the values of k. However, a straightforward approach can also be used. So for n equal to 15 and alpha equal to 7, h of k is equal to at omega equal to 2 pi k by 15. So we get h of k equal to e power minus j 7 2 pi k by 15. So e power minus j 14 pi k by 15 for k equal to 0, 1, 2 up to 14. So a mapping of this omega to k plane is given as we need to calculate the value of k from 0 to 14 and the corresponding value of omega for this value of k is found out over here. So the alpha is nothing but the center of symmetry here, which is nothing but 14 by 15 for our particular problem. The center of symmetry here is 14 pi by 15, which is nothing but alpha. So h of k equal to, we can observe that this table has to be plotted over here. So we can observe that omega equal to 0 will obviously lie over here. And 2 pi by, our cutoff frequency is pi by 4. So that should be noted. So 2 pi by 15 will be definitely lesser than pi by 4, and hence 1, k equal to 1 is taken over here, right? K equal to 2, which is 4 pi by 15, is definitely greater than 45 degrees. So k equal to 2 is taken over here. So similarly, all these values are taken over here. So finally, 26 pi by 15 is also lesser than the 7 pi by 4, and hence it is plotted over here. 28 pi by 15 is greater. So finally, we get over here. The same k equal to 0 will again repeat at 2 pi. However, considering the point of symmetry, we need not consider the second half of a low pass filter. We can consider only the values of k from 0 up to 7 for calculating our order of the, for calculating the response for order of the filter n equal to 15. This is exploitation of the symmetrical property. So the value of k equal to 0, 1. So we can see that in this 0 to 7, the h of k has a finite value, the magnitude is equal to 1 or the response is equal to e power only for the values of k equal to 0 and 1. For all other values of k, this h of k is 0. Hence, we need to obtain the problem like this, which is very, very important. Moving on. Now, the order of the filter is n is odd, where n equal to 15. So, we choose the equation for impulse response, h of n, because step 3 is identification of the impulse response. So, we choose the corresponding formula for n odd. We substitute 1 by 15, h of 0, k equal to 1 to 7. So, you can see that we are taking the value of k only from 1 to 7 for order of the filter n equal to 15. So, h of 0 to summation k equal to 1 to 7, a real part of e power, h of k is nothing but, so we can see that why we are taking only as k equal to 1 is, already k equal to 0 is taken. In our problem, only for k equal to 1, we have a magnitude over here. For all other points, it is 0. So, we just take k equal to 1. So, 2 summation k equal to 1. Substitute h of k, e power minus j 14 pi k by 15. Since it's only one value, we simply write it as e power minus j, k equal to 1 you substitute. So, e power minus j 14 pi by 15, e power j 2 pi n by 15. Taking this as common, 2 pi 15 into n by 7. So, real part of this is nothing but cos of 2 pi into n minus 7 by 15. So, this is the equation for determining your h of n. Or this is the impulse response of your FAR filter. Now, from this equation, we can easily identify what are the filter coefficients. So, we know the property that h of n equal to h of n minus 1 minus n for a symmetrical FAR filter. So, substituting for n equal to 0, we get h of 0 is equal to obviously 15 minus 1, 14. Minus 0, which is h of 14. Substitute here. While calculating, take the value of pi as 180 degrees. Keep it in degree mode and you can use it as pi. So, calculate minus 0.063 and h of 1 will be equal to h of 13 and the value is calculated. So, you can see that it proceeds on till h of 6 will be equal to h of 8. The center of symmetry here for this filter is h of 7. Which is equal to 0.2, right? So, these are the filter coefficients and you can put a pause and analyze the symmetrical property of this filter. So, you can observe here that if you take this filter, h of 0, whatever value you get, h of 0 will be symmetrical with h of 14. H of 1 will be symmetrical, whatever coefficient we get will be symmetrical with 13. It goes on in this manner for 2 and everything. And in the center, we have 7, which is nothing but a separate value and it is 0.2 or whatever the filter coefficient it is. So, you can see or analyze the symmetric property over here. Moving on to the next step. We need to identify the transfer function of the filter because our ultimate aim is we have to develop a filter structure. So, h of z is summation n equal to 0 to n minus 1, h of n z power minus 1. So, just expand for different values. Exploit the symmetry property. So, wherever I have h of 14, it's replaced by h of 0, h of 13 by 1, h of 12 by 2 and go on. Then, take in common. Substitute the values of h of 0, h of 1. So, this is the equation for h of z that we obtain. Transforming this h of z into a linear phase FAR filter for n equal to odd. So, we can see that we have n is equal to 15, right? So, as per our equation, we can see that we have the maximum delay as 14, right? Z power minus 14. So, we need to introduce 14 such delays. So, you can see that 7 delays on the top and 7 delays on the bottom. The first one is x of z, okay, plus z power minus 14. So, it traverses entirely over here, and what we get here is z power minus 14 into x of z. Both are added, and that is multiplied by h of 0, which is what is given over here. Similarly, the next one will be x of 1, and then z power minus 13. Both are added, multiplied by h of 1. It's important to understand that h of 7, which is nothing but 0.2 into z power minus 7, is given as 7 delays multiplied by 0.2. There is no addition over here because the 7th one is a center of symmetry. So directly we take here 0.2, and all these individual values are summed together to obtain the final value of y of z. Thank you, students.